Welcome to the highlights of match number two of the Hero CPL 2017. The Ghana Amazon Warriors taking on the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots in the first match here in the USA this season. Amazon Warriors were asked to bat first, and there was some fortune for Martin Guptill as he just got back in time. There was a drop chance by Carlos Brathwaite as well off the bat of Chadwick Walton. Really was the story of the day before Martin Guptill got into his stride off some full pitch bowling from the left-arm seam of Cottrell. He went full again. Guptill took full toll of the proceedings. Another drop chance by big Carlos Brathwaite again. Guptill, Alan Wilkins was in stride.
He was until he tried once too often, and then Budgery, just a little bit quicker, got one through. But then we saw Chadwick Walton. Catches kept going down though, and the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots weren't helping their cause. Eventually, one was taken by Carter in the deep.
Then Hassan Ali came into the attack, and he's done so very well in that phase of the innings in white ball cricket, picking up a couple of wickets, a second of those Taylor holding out to mid-wicket.
Yeah, this time not finding his length, looking for the Yorker. Budgery coming back into the attack. That was a straight six by Walton. Walton's 50 coming up, and another even better blow over extra, inside out. And then this was the last over, it's an extraordinary last over. Walton Parrish caught by Nabi at third man. Then we saw the end of Kimo Paul, a brilliant catch by Jonathan Carter, one of the best of the day. And then everything happened at the end. This was Sohail Tanveer run out at the end.
Let's have a look at the run chase. Evan Lewis was struck plumb in front by Stephen Jacobs. He's been a four-man, Evan Lewis, and that was a big wicket for the Warriors to get. Chris Gayle was nudging and deflecting early in his innings, trying to establish himself, and he did for one lovely stroke down the ground. But then Riyad Emery proved too much for him, just beating him with a little bit of pace and some bounce.
Yes, he did, because he bowled three very good dot balls to Chris Gayle. Remember, they're only chasing 124 to win this match. And a little nick behind as Emmerich again back in the fray.
Yeah, getting rid of Hafiz. And the innings really stuttered and started for a period of time there. Another catch going unfolded in. The substitute couldn't hold on. And then a run out of Devon Thomas had reduced the innings quite significantly. In fact, at one stage they were 57 for 5. And then Brandon King succumbing to Stephen Jacobs.
Meanwhile, Carlos Brathwaite came in, and we know what he can do. He can absolutely demolish an attack. He can destroy reputations and confidence. And that's what he did. He set about the bowling in such emphatic style. And Brathwaite was almost taking it home for St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. Eventually he perished, caught by Mohammed Otombia for 31. But with time running out, the Patriots eventually getting home with Nabi not out and Carter not out 29. It's the first time they've beaten them in the Caribbean Premier League in 5 years.
Yeah, some solidity in that partnership between Carter and Nabi, really sealing the issue for the Patriots, going on to win by 4 wickets. And a good win over the Amazon Warriors, who've had the wood over them historically.
It's how we play.